From a potential government experiment to a big Bigfoot curse, here are some top 5 Bigfoot urban legends. Number 5 on this list is that Bigfoot was a government experiment. The legend of Bigfoot has been circulating around the globe for quite some time now. Some of the earliest records of the creature are from the late 1800s when a British Columbian newspaper wrote about a gorilla type of creature that was wandering around the woods in the area. Since then, the rumors and the lore have exploded and reached an all-time high in the 70s. This was also around the time that the FBI got involved. The American government actually got involved with the investigations that were happening with Bigfoot in the 1970s. Peter Byrne, who's a leading expert on Bigfoot, sent some unidentified hair to the FBI and told them that his group needed the government's help. They'd found the hairs and weren't sure what kind of animal it belonged to. They thought that this hair may be some of the first legitimate proof of a new species or potentially even Bigfoot. The crazy thing was that the FBI, they took it seriously. They snatched up the hairs and ran some tests on them, eventually concluding that they were actually the hairs of a deer. But the fact that the FBI, a super high-ranking government agency, took actual time and money to investigate these claims, well, it got people speculating that the government maybe had something to do with Bigfoot in the first place. The possibility of a government experiment that resulted in the creation of Bigfoot is a growing theory in the community. The government may have been performing some tests on animals, created Bigfoot, and then through some accident, Bigfoot got loose. I imagine that the government wouldn't want to own up to something like this because not only would it make them look highly inept to let a massive animal like this out on the loose, but there would also be a lot of moral questions being thrown at them from the public about genetic mutation like that. We've seen scientists in other countries before conduct genetic mutations like this, so it's not completely unrealistic to believe that this could have actually been the origin of Bigfoot. What makes this so scary though is that if this truly was the case, then what other creatures are the government engineering right now behind closed doors that we don't know about? Number 4 on this list is the Bigfoot species. What's scarier than just one Bigfoot? How about an entire colony of them? Bigfoot has often been depicted as a giant ape-like cryptid that stands anywhere from 6 to 15 feet tall. It stands on 2 legs, can emit a super high-pitched cry that can destroy someone's eardrums, and has a footstep that is roughly 24 inches in length. This massive size also contributes to the reports of its massive strength as well, with most people thinking that it's several times stronger than the strongest bear we have on the planet. All this being said, you certainly wouldn't want to run into this thing in the forest by yourself. The good news is that running into Bigfoot would be pretty hard to do because many people believe that there's only one Bigfoot. There are thousands of forests around the world, and the likelihood of running into the one singular Bigfoot, well, it's pretty slim. However, your odds increase dramatically if, well, there's actually a collection of these creatures. Assuming that Bigfoot wasn't a one-off government experiment, then it's pretty ridiculous for us to assume that there's only one of these creatures. Bigfoot would be a totally new species that we've never seen before, and to even get to this point of evolution, there would have needed to be more of them along the way. It should also be noted that there have been sightings of this beast in the forests of British Columbia and California, but then also a bunch of sightings in places like Maine and Ohio. Maine and Ohio are pretty far from British Columbia and California, and unless this singular Bigfoot is the most athletic creature on the planet, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense that it would regularly be running back and forth between these two places. What's far more likely is that there are several Bigfoot families in these regions. That potentially there's one or two families of the species in the West and a few in the East as well. That would still fit into the narrative of sightings being very rare, but would make a lot more sense than the singular Sasquatch. Geez, try saying that 5 times fast, guys. Singular Sasquatch, it's tough. If this is the case though, then it means that Bigfoot is probably slowly growing in number. Without any natural predators, one would think that as the years go by, more Sasquatches will continue to pop up, which in turn drastically increases the chance that we do have an encounter with this thing in the forest one day. Number 3 on this list is that Bigfoot is actually a demon. For years, Bigfoot has been talked about as being a creature, a massive mystical ape that may have evolved from gorillas at some point to become what it is now. But this also seems a tad bit far-fetched based on how little sightings there are of it. How is it possible that a creature that's so big hasn't ever been confirmed? The only explanation that I can think of is that Bigfoot's actually a demon. If Bigfoot is actually a mythical demon creature from hell, then it makes sense why we don't have regular sightings of it. It can go between hell and earth whenever it feels like and potentially has the capability to turn invisible if it wants. If it was a demon, then it would remind me a lot of some of the ancient Greek demon creatures from mythology. Hades' three-headed dog, Cerberus, comes to mind as a potential comparison. Now, if Bigfoot was actually a demonic creature from hell, then it begs the question, what is it doing here? Well, we may never know that. Sometimes devilish creatures just come to Earth for the sake of coming to Earth. For instance, there's an area called the Devil's Tramping Grounds in North Carolina where it's believed that the devil comes often and dances there. It's possible that Bigfoot does something similar in the forests of North America. It's also possible, however, that Bigfoot is up to some demonic mission. Potentially it's tasked with having individuals go missing in the forest and bringing them back to hell. Or maybe it's just the keeper of these woods and haunts them like a ghost would a house. Whatever the case is, I actually much prefer the idea that Bigfoot is just a big ape that has evolved. The second that we start throwing in the idea of a demon, he gets way more dangerous in my opinion. Number two on this list is the Bigfoot curse. We've talked already in this video about how Bigfoot could have been an experiment done by the government, or maybe just a product of evolution, but what if there's an actual curse that's going on here? Some of the First Nations who were around during the beginning of the Bigfoot legend believed that Bigfoot was actually a man that had been turned into this hunking, hairy beast and had been given special powers and abilities. These powers and abilities, though, were at the cost of his human appearance, memories, and ability to communicate with our species in general. They worried that this curse could be passed on, and that if you didn't respect the forest, that this curse may find you next. This curse legend also sort of started the association with Bigfoot and environmental care. For a while there, Bigfoot was portrayed as an evil creature lurking around the woods, ready to pounce on unsuspecting victims. But in the 80s, the narrative changed a little bit. Bigfoot could potentially be the guardian of the forest and someone who's here to remind us that we need to protect our environment. This urban legend takes that a step further and says that this creature was actually once a person. Maybe this person who was cursed to be Bigfoot didn't care enough about our forests, and now they're cursed to forever be this giant beast and to live in the woods alone. This would be to show someone what it's like to have this forest be your home. I like the idea behind this curse, like I think all of us should be a little bit more environmentally conscious. However, it's kind of scary to think that I could turn into Bigfoot and live alone, misunderstood in the woods for the rest of my life. Probably not the coolest existence, to be honest. Number one on this list is the Bigfoot omen. Seeing Bigfoot is something that only a handful of people have ever done in their lives. This is why, to this day, its existence hasn't been able to be confirmed. As cool as it would be to see this creature and know for sure that the stories are accurate, some say that it might be the worst omen of your life. Is it possible that all of the limited sightings of Bigfoot through the years haven't just been a coincidence, but they've actually been on purpose? What if Bigfoot chooses who it shows itself to? What if these encounters aren't just by chance, but it's actually an omen? This is what a lot of people believe in regards to this creature. The Ojibwe of the Northern Plains believed that seeing this beast was an omen of bad luck or a warning of incoming misfortune. This is especially scary for all those Bigfoot enthusiasts out there trying to find Bigfoot, because if you ever actually do see the beast, then it might be the last thing you ever do. Personally, I find this urban legend to be a tad bit hard to believe. Bigfoot is a legendary creature that's said to be magnificent and majestic. Seeing this thing out in the wild, assuming it doesn't attack you, would honestly be a life-changing event. I would have hoped that seeing it would have even brought you good luck. Fingers crossed that my version of events is the right one, and seeing this creature isn't an indicator of an unavoidable morbid future. Well, there you have it, guys. That is our list of the top 5 scary Bigfoot urban legends. Please comment down below what you thought about these legends and some other potential urban legends that you've heard about in regards to Bigfoot before. I've been your host, Nicholas Playlog. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.